ومن ولا.
Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today, inshallah ta'ala, continuing our subject of finding, reflecting on moral character and good conduct as the aim of the message of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in this religion. So where is this morality and good conduct in our worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Last time we discussed that on the matter of the testimony of faith, La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah, and inshallah today we will reflect a little bit on where is husnul khuluq, morality and good conduct in our prayers. First, let us mention what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the prayer. When he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. Establish the prayer regularly, as ordained. Indeed, the prayer will prevent the believer from doing any fahsha and munkar, and we will explain. Fahsha, in fact, is an Arabic word that relates to all the issues, the matters, whether they are words or actions that are shameful. People always chant them and never do them, especially publicly. Whatever you find yourself by nature hating it and disowning it and distancing yourself from it, that is fahsha. That is what is immoral actions are. However, munkar is also a technical term in the Islamic heritage that relates to all the actions and deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the lawgiver and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, also excluded them from morality and good conduct. Munkar means like this is not known here in this system. That is the nakira, something that we don't know in the deen. So, fahsha and munkar, in fact, the opposite of them is morality and good conduct. So, this is the purpose of the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also the purpose in the prayer. You pray for this. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first of all, regarding dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described what happens when you stand before Him and pray. He said in the hadith, the sacred hadith, that prayer is divided between me and my slave. When my slave says, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, praise be to Allah, the Lord of the worlds, I will say, my servant or slave, praise me. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, he will say, my slave is now glorifying me and giving good assumptions of me. Maliki Yawm al-Din, having faith in me and also glorifying. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, here is when you say, it is you who we worship and it is you who we seek support from. About this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, now this is between me and my servant, and for my servant is what he is requiring, requesting or asking. So, praising me. Remember, we mentioned the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what would Allah do with you? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put you into suffering and punishment if you are believing and you are great. So being thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of the issues that inshallah is going to save you from the punishment of Allah. And for this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His own mercy on us, He made it obligatory in our prayers 5 times a day that you stand before Him and you say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Praise be to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. However, the point today is that don't actually just say it with your tongue while your heart is not there with it and in it. Be aware of what you are doing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be heedful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because from the definitions of consciousness is that you do what you do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for what is going to happen after this. So, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be grateful to Him. And also, when you come to إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ, in fact here, you are confessing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that all your worship is to Him. And that is acknowledging Him as your Lord and your God. However, إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ means we seek also your help from all the matters that may keep us away from you. And these are our own enemies, yourself and the devil. You seek the help against them. Because here when you say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, that is what you need to do, He created for it, and you don't want to do anything other than this. And that is why you seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is husnul khuluq, or the morality and good conduct with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, as for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِ, perform the prayer for my remembrance. And the remembrance of Allah, or dhikrullah, in fact, it has the entire meaning of the deen again. Part of it, part of the meaning that we may share today is that you should not actually just keep your tongue in the remembrance of Allah while your heart is heedless. The presence of your Lord in your heart is better than your mentioning with your tongue. And I really want you to reflect on this. Keeping Him in your heart is better than just mentioning the words of praise. And that is in fact for a very important induction here. If it is in your heart, morality and good conduct will be the result. You will never do anything which is not the perfection of beauty. As scholars in this area said, the one who have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of the unseen means you don't see Him, but you have faith in Him more than what you see. If you arrive at that level, then all your actions and all your words will be beautiful. The one who is aware of Allah, that kind of awareness, then all their deeds and actions will be beautified. And this is not only with Allah and His Messenger, inshallah, it is also with all the creation. And I give an example. Why there are in our streets, especially in this part of the world, there are these cameras observing people and trying to make our community safe? Because people, when they see that there is someone observing, they may be deterred from doing anything wrong. But what I want to say is how about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is not in need of these security cameras? Allah, who is looking and looking all the time directly to you, your heart, and what you do. How about Him? That is the muraqabah, muraqabah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you observe Him all the time, bi-iznillah, by His will, inshallah, all your actions will be sound. However, also from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to all scholars, is as-salatu ala nabi, the prayer upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because that is the zikr that Allah Himself and His angels are doing all the time. And also He enjoined it on us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صلِّ وبارك عليه وعلى والديه وآله يا أكرم الأكرمين. And look at the prayer. First of all, let me start with what Shafi'i said regarding the Salah ala Nabi in the prayer. He said, whoever does not mention the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam with his Salah, means you make the Salah in your fourth prayer, he said your fourth is in vain. It doesn't count. And the sanad, the evidence of the Imam here for this is that the hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said to one of the Sahaba, don't you know that Allah will not accept any kind of deen if I am not mentioned in it? That is the evidence. And the prayer, in fact, is the model here. You start it. When you hear the Azan, you know that now it is time. And the Azan is La ilaha illallah, Ashhadu an La ilaha illallah, wa Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. So there is the mention here, even in announcing the time of the prayer. And when you stand for it, the Iqam, and it is also Salah ala Nabi mentioned, the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when you finish from it, Tashahud, and it is Salah ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brother and sister, always, inshallah, keep to this system of morality and good conduct with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And take the prayer as the induction of this, inshallah, so that we will walk among all human beings, inshallah, as an ummah that is the best to be produced for humanity, inshallah, by sharing this goodness, inshallah, with them. اللهم إنا نسألك في هذا اليوم الفضيل أن لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا